The XTS is a modular system. It's comprised of a PC that does all the control. It's got movers that move around the system and are on a rail. And then there's various motor modules that can be assembled to give us the appropriate form of the track that we would like. We have inside radii, outside radii, that can all be combined together in different formats. For such a modular system, we require also modular software. And what we can do with the XTS is we simply scan the system in as it's built. This then gives us a graphical format of where everything is. We add then the appropriate number of movers to the system. Once we have all the movers in, we can then start the system. So going from a system that's not running to a system that has the first mover moving takes less than 5 to 10 minutes. Once we have the program, or once we have the movers in the system, now we can start writing the code. And the code that we write now has all the tools for the normal toolkit. We have built-in collision avoidance functions. We can build in all the queuing, so the movers automatically form the queues that are required. And all of it programs exactly the same as normal TwinCAT axes. So users that are familiar already with TwinCAT will have a very quick time of taking an XTS system and getting it up and running. Once we have the system configured in, then we have visualization. When it comes time to commission my XTS, maybe I have a very long XTS, the movers are 30 meters or 100 feet away, and it's very difficult to go run around the machine and find them all. We have a visualization tool, and the visualization tool can be connected from anywhere, even multiple PCs at the same time. And this allows us to see all the movers in real time, where they are, what they're doing, which movers in which position to verify that everything is correct during the commissioning process. But most important is, yes, that's great. When everything is all built, we can start programming it. The most important is that we're able to start programming and simulating the system before it's built. And with us, we have the capability to simulate everything. I can set up a complete configuration of my desired XTS system, add all the movers in. I can then write all of the code that I need to get my system up and running. And I can prove everything out beforehand, before anything is even assembled. I can figure out how long my XTS needs to be, how many movers I need to have, and I can do all of this prior to anything being built. Here we have a fully simulated setup. We can play with the length of the XTS, how long the L section should be. We can add and remove stations. We can double up or make 5, 6, 7 parallel processing points in each individual station. We can also determine how long each station should operate. What happens in a station takes more time. Can we speed a station up and have it take less time? How many movers do we need in the full system? So in the beginning, we would think that station one with the longest processing time would be the bottleneck, that movers would queue up between station 12 and station one. But we see, in fact, that station 12 seems to be the bottleneck. The movers, perhaps station 12 could do a little bit better with another parallel processing point. And then we see back here at station 8 that station 8 is actually the bottleneck. More and more movers queue up at station 8. If we added too many movers into the system, we'd find that the movers will queue all the way back up into station 7, inhibiting station 7's processing time. With such a setup, we can fully see how my machine is going to behave before anything's built. And the most important part is that the simulation software that we write here is not just simulation software. It's the full software that's going to run the machine later once it's finished. So the code that I write to make this simulation go is the same code that I will use later to commission the machine once it's completed. So with a fully modular XTS and modular software, we can very quickly determine the right size of a machine before any components are ordered and built and put together.